Today we're going to talk about how to control a fan on the BigTreeTech SKR version 1.4. So I need to point out a couple of things here. We have four fan ports on this board, or power ports. So I'm going to point them out. So we have fan 0, fan 1, fan 2, and fan 3. Now, the unique thing about this one is power controlled. So you have your positive end right here and your negative end right here. So this would be your ground for your pin. This, on the other hand, is direct power. So it's either going to be 12 or 24 volts, depending upon your power supply. Now I'm going to be using 12 volts to control it. And then this one is either 12 or 20 volts. Excuse me, 12 or 24 volts, as well as this one. So I'm going to show you how to hook this up. So because it's plus 5 on the right side, or 12 volts, excuse me, you're going to plug in the red side to the right and the black side to the left. So it's going to go like this. So what we need to do now is actually load the firmware. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to connect the big side of the USB to the board. And the small side I'm going to connect to the computer. And you're going to hear a beep in a moment. Now, keep in mind that on this board, I have the jumper set for USB. If I had had it on the other two pins, then it would be direct power. Okay, to start with, as you can see, we have a file called firmware.cur. This is on the SD drive that appears as a USB drive on the SKR version 1.4. This was the last firmware loaded, thus firmware.cur. So what I want to do now is actually download the Marlin firmware. So I have it up over here. So we're going to go with the latest release zip. So I'm going to click on this. This is going to take a moment to download. Just so you know, no one's paying me or sponsoring me to do this tutorial. But I will be placing Amazon affiliate links in the description for your convenience. So the next thing that we want to do is we want to click on Show in Folder. Now, inside the folder, we have our zip. So we're going to right click, we're going to click on Extract, and then we're going to click the Extract button. This may take a moment to extract. So I'm going to look over in Platform IO, which is loaded as an extension on VS Code. So I'm going to click over here to prepare it. What we're going to do is we're going to open a folder when it fully unzips. And that should be just a moment from now. As you can see, it's moving quite quickly. So let's take a look at it here. We're at 65, 66. So any second now, we'll be able to actually do the open folder. Okay, so I'm going to click on Open Folder. And it's already mapped to the folder in my downloads directory, but we need to go one folder deeper, and then we need to do select folder. So now that we have this actually open, what we need to do is actually set it up for our particular board, which is the SKR version 1.4. So I'm going to click on Marlin, then Source, then Core, then Boards.h. Inside boards.h, I'm going to do a search on SKR underscore B1, so it's right here. So I'm going to copy this. And I'm going to close out of boards.h. But while I'm here, I want to show you something. So inside the core folder, we're actually going to go up a directory and go to pins folder. Now we know that this actual chipset is the LPC 1768. We're going to open this up. And as you can see, we actually have a folder right here with pins underscore BTT SKR underscore V1 underscore 4.h. This is our header file for our pins. So we can actually search around here and figure out what the pins are. So I'm going to do a search on fan. And apparently I'm not seeing anything, which is okay. But if I'm not actually seeing the fan pin, it may be called something else. As you can see up here, there's different pins that are being used for like soft cereal. And then we have probably, let's see, our steppers have separate pins by themselves. And we have end stops someplace in here as well. But we have stall guard pins. It's very interesting. It shows the layout of your board. But in our case, we're not sure what the pin is called. So what we're going to do is cheat. We're going to go over to the actual SKR manual for 1.4. And we're going to see that fan 0 is the fan that we're looking for. So I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to see what it actually says for it. It's right down here. So here it is. If we zoom in, you can see that fan 0 has a plus on the top side and a minus on the other side. But over here, it says 2.3. So that is our fan pin port. So in order to search for this, we can go over here and we could probably say, let's see, control F, we're going to say P3 underscore, and we can actually run through all of the P3s based on what we're seeing over here, but it's actually P2, pardon me for that. So it's going to be 2 underscore. And what we're looking for is like 0, 3, or 3. So let's see what we can find here. So we can scroll through these rather quickly. So it doesn't look like I'm actually finding it, which is okay. It may be specified as something else. So apparently we're not finding it. So let's scroll to the top of the file and see if there's any includes around here, or maybe even the bottom. So I'm going to page down to the bottom of this file. And it has a pins underscore BTT underscore SKR underscore common dot H. So that means that it has a file that's in common with other BigTreeTech things. So what we can see right here is this is the common file. So I'm going to click on that. And I'm actually going to scroll down because it's saying what the actual chipset is here. We can actually now look to see if we can find that pin. So here's the actual fan pin that we were looking for. And it, sure enough, is labeled fan. So it's actually copying a portion of this into here. When it's compiling, it's not actually copied, but it's included. So I'm going to close this down. And now I'm going to go over to configuration.h to set this up. So I'm going to do a search on motherboard. I'm going to highlight the ramps board and paste our board over it. So now we're set for that. Now we need to set our actual serial port to -1. And then that's all we need to do to set up the fan for configuration.h. If we had special fans that we wanted to turn on automatically, then we would use configuration-advanced.h. And there's some down in here if you search on fan. But that's something where you can use something, a fan extender, or some way to extend another fan based on what you're working with. But seeing how we don't have that set up at the moment, I'm just going to focus on what we're talking about here. So I'm going to go to platformio.ini, and what we need to do is change our default environment. So I'm going to change this to LPC1768 because we know that's the chipset for the SKR version 1.4. It's not for the turbo. The turbo would actually be 1769 for the chipset, and the actual board type would be slightly different. So So down here, it would actually be this one if you're using turbo. But seeing how we don't really want to worry about that right now, we just want to understand the process. I'm going to close out of boards.h. And what we're going to do is we're actually going to press the upload button. This will compile or build our changes and then upload it to our board. So I'm going to click on that. Okay, now that you can see that it actually succeeded for a build, we can double check it by scrolling up and making sure our chipset built, which it did. So we can actually go over to our USB drive for the SKR version 1.4, and we can check that it's here, and it is. So I'm going to remove the USB drive for a second. Then I'm going to reconnect it. And as you can see, it's just updated. So as you can see, I have wired up the actual power supply and it's unplugged, but I need to change the actual jumper. So I'm going to remove the USB for a second. I'm going to move the jumper over to the next two set of pins. Then I'm going to reconnect the actual USB. So you can see there's no power. Now I'm going to actually plug this in and energize the system. Now keep in mind, once I've energized the system, you don't want to touch any of the board. Okay, before we test the fan, we need to know what the G code is. And I've looked it up on Marlin, it's M106, and it's set fan speed. So I'm going to click on this. You can see a description of the command. So down here, they actually show how to do it. So the fan index in our case is going to be our first fan, which is going to be P0. Our speed is going to be from 0 to 255. And then what we can do now is actually try it out. So I'm going to go over to the folder for Pronterface. So I'm going to open up print run. Then I'm going to open up the executable for Pronterface. I'm going to connect to the device. As you can see, it says printer is now online. The fan is currently not running. So we're going to type M106P0 for the first fan. Then we're going to say S for the speed, and we're going to say 200. Then I'm going to press enter and watch what happens. So as you can see, the fan is now running. If you want to actually shut the fan off, you can do S0 and press enter, and that will shut down your fan. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.